Five.
Go. It's Feel Good Friday of Clara Bella and Katie. Action. Hi everybody, so welcome to Feel Good Friday from Clara Bella. Today we have the lovely Katie McDermott with us, who's on series two of Love Island, is an entrepreneur, beauty makeup artist, along with a lot of other things. And today we are going to do a series of fun challenges to make everybody feel like it's Friday and get in that spirit.
Yeehaw.
So at the end of this live broadcast, there's also going to be a huge competition announced, so make sure you stay tuned for that because you won't get the details of how to enter unless you do. So we're going to start today's session with a Q&A. So I'm going to ask Katie some questions and she's going to answer them as truthfully as possible.
Truthfully.
So our first question is, who is the most famous person in your phone book? And you've got to be truthful.
I don't know. I feel like I need to have a look.
Have a look.
I want to say someone like Brad Pitt, but I'd be lying.
Well, if it is, I'll have your phone. And I'll be ringing him.
Do you know what? I'm really bad. I'm one of the people that don't say people's numbers. I know.
Then you're not going to know who's ringing.
Famous?
Yeah. You see, in mine, it's probably Rylan, but I'm thinking you might have somebody like Justin Bieber.
Oh, I wish. Yeah, oh my God, I'm just trying to think. I'm going to sound really boring, I think, actually.
What about the guy who does the voiceover for Love Island?
Yeah, I have Ian.
I just got Ian's.
Caroline Flack.
Caroline Flack, sorry,
I forgot about Caz yet. I have Caroline.
Fabulous. Right, so our second question is a little bit more complex, but how do you handle competition in your chosen lines of work? So like reality TV, makeup and your beauty line, how do you handle competition? And have you had any sort of negativity or competition around it?
I mean, the reality industry is quite a fickle industry, and it's not always the nicest industry at times, but there's a little bit of like stigma going around at the moment with like reality stars, and like why as soon as you become a reality star you release a makeup range. I get quite upset by that because I'm like, that's my passion. I'm a trained makeup artist. I've done makeup since I was 15 years old. I studied it 2-3 years at college. I worked at MAC, and then I worked at Charlotte Tilbury, and then worked on films, and then obviously on Love Island. But it's always been a passion of mine because that's what I'm trained in. So obviously I was going to do a makeup range because that's my occupation.
So because it's your occupation, your passion, you're just not putting your name to something. Like some are, you know it, you've lived it and you've breathed it, and that's the difference. So do you get a lot of competition then in that particular area?
Oh yeah, massively. There was even some stuff at the weekend, if you guys follow me on Twitter, like with a reality star who has a makeup brand as well. Yeah, I'm not going to get too much into it, but I like to say that I stand out a little bit more because I am a professional makeup artist and I offer masterclasses.
And you're trained in it and it's what you've done and all.
Yeah, I'm trained in it. So.
And women should empower women.
Yeah,
in my opinion. You know, there's a lot of people making bags. Good on them.
Yeah.
Empower women, empower people what they do.
And I kind of like a little bit of, like, I say healthy competition. Not, like, nasty competition, but it kind of encourages you to want to do better, exactly. Do more. It's nice, isn't it? If it's just you doing it, then... Yeah. But...
So note to self, haters, you only lift us up, you don't pull us.
Yeah, that is so true.
It's true. Right, so our third question is, give us one unknown fun fact about Katie.
Do you know what, I hate when people ask that, because I feel really boring. I'm like, what do I think? Fun fact?
I said this to John, though, someone asked me, I wouldn't know what to say.
Thumbs.
What's that? Fun?
Thumbs, yeah.
Oh my God, that's not me! What's happening?
We'll talk about that later.
Tell me, Mum.
Yeah,
fun
they're
fact.
Awful. Yeah.
Fun fact. I can do the alphabet and sign language.
Really?
Yeah.
Go for it. Go for it.
Okay.
That's an achievement.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, B, W, X, Y, Z.
Oh, skills! Top skills!
Brilliant!
I did actually know how to do it a little bit more. There was, when I was in primary school, someone was like partially deaf. So our teacher used to teach us how to do like happy birthday, like just do the alphabet and like just some basic stuff. I have forgotten a bit of it, but
that's
all
right. That's a really big skill to have. Well done, you. So that's the end of our Q&A session. That wasn't too bad, was it?
No, it wasn't too bad.
Found out some fun facts. Yeah. Caroline's in your phone. Yeah. John, good old friend, might be pleased about that. So the next challenge... I'm so getting divorced. So the next challenge is the guess the celebrity challenge.
Guess the celebrity challenge.
So basically the format is I have drawn and painted three well-known celebrities and it is Katie's job to identify the celebrity.
Okay, they're easy.
I promise you they're not that hard. So this is our first one.
They so on away. Does the outfit give it away?
Think my era of music.
Is it Baby Spice?
No.
No, the other one. What's the other one? Was it Posh or Sporty?
Ginger.
Jerry
Halliwell.
Oh, yeah.
Ginger Spice. I did say when I drew that. Yeah, definitely a Spice Girl, but I thought, that's my era of music, so that is Jerry Halliwell.
I get it half right.
Yeah, you get half a point.
Half a point.
Yeah, because you got that it was Jerry.
I know, I was a bit too excited, so I was like, come on, go Spice Girl.
Just naming them. So that is the first one. So the second one... Look in the picture for clues with this one.
Is it me?
Yes!
I love that!
Yeah,
I love it! That. Did you draw that?
Yeah,
all of them.
Yeah.
Oh my god, all of them.
You've got your water bottle. I was going to put a bag on there saying, bag, okay, do something. I thought, no, that gives it away. So I thought, if I just do the water bottle, it's quite.
Do you know, I didn't see that at first. I wouldn't have guessed. But you made it really tan. I thought we could pay for that.
Well, it's you at Love Island when you were on Love Island. She did wear a yellow bikini at one point. Yeah. So this is our third and final one, which I think you might have a bit of difficulty with, but then I don't know. We'll just give it a go. Yeah. We can give you some clues if you do.
Okay.
Think outrageous.
Meat dress.
Yeah, dress out
with
meat if you wore a dress
out. Lady Gaga.
Yes!
I remember the meat dress because I was like, oh,
I know, that is awful. So that was a grand score of 2.5.
2.5.
I don't know what I was with that.
It's really good.
I was looking at them and rubbish.
No, you did brilliant.
Oh, I love them.
Yes, so you can keep that one. Brilliant! So what score was it? Round me 2.5.
2.5.
So we're going to have a leaderboard. We're hoping to get more celebrities in over time, so we're going to have a leaderboard like Top Gear.
Oh my god, I love that! That's so cool.
Then we'll have to
You're winning at the minute.
I won't win. People get three.
Right, so the next part of our Feel Good Friday is painting a Clarabella. So not many people realise, some do, some don't, that are avid Clarabella followers, that all our bags, jute bags, are hand-painted by artists, every single one. So I'm going to, we've got the body, so it's a little bit less difficult. I'm going to talk you through how to paint a bag.
Do you know what, Melissa, you're all going to laugh at me, I'm going to
it's
be so bad.
It's fine, it will be fine. John's done it, I know loads of people that have done it. It's a giggle, we'll have fun. So you need your pen first.
Oh, pen first?
Yes, pen. Right. So what we're going to do first is we're going to do the outline of a head. Feel free to look at any of these So first thing we do is her head shape, which is slightly tilted, but it doesn't matter.
I can't even draw a circle.
You don't need
square.
To. That's fine. Can you have a square,
square
head?
Square heads
are fine. Give us a lunch, Bob. So if you want, do you want to watch me do it or do you want to follow me do it?
I will... watch you.
Okay, so I'm gonna, because the neck's already in, I'm gonna start by doing one half. So to there.
Oh my god. I'm just gonna do it.
Just
shake your hands.
Honestly, don't even worry about it. It's part of the comedy. That's good. So then to the other side, just basically the same again. Just a little
I'm like a bit cap handed. I can't
a
like.
A bit bigger.
A bit bigger?
Yeah.
Well, it's hard, isn't it? Because it's like short.
Yeah.
Oh, sugar. Oh, no.
No, that's fine.
You're doing well.
Brilliant. There you go. That's good.
Twins.
Twin heads. So the next bit is the eyes. So the shape is again sort of circle, so we'll do the bottom circle first, like this. No, that's it. And then the top one, so go from about this point there and then arch it out and over, coming down at that side. Mine's not looking the best at the moment either. I'm looking at mine and thinking, what am I doing?
And then my eyes look big.
That's fine. And then the same at the other side, but you need to try and sort of match them up. So curve it round.
It's actually harder because it's not on paper.
Yeah, it's really
that's
hard.
That's going to be my excuse.
Well, no, but people don't realise how difficult this is to draw in. It's rough.
Yeah,
it's due, but it is like potatoes. There you go. And then again, at the top on the other side, so repeat what you did with this side. So it's just up and over. Mine's got one eye bigger than the other as well. It's because I'm doing it slowly. Normally I go dip, 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 dip. And it's
my cold. Eyes are more like, yours are round and mine are more, just cold, start out.
Flat. Yeah. So then for the inner of the eye, it's just making that circle like that. See, not as bad as this is what you said. A bit wonky, but
yeah,
that's fine.
No, no, that's your great eyes.
So then the nose, did you ever draw a bird in skull? And you just do it like that. So the nose is like this, so just like that.
Oh, I know what you mean.
Sorry. Yeah,
I'm drawing a bear. Like
your
bird.
No, it's like when you do them in school. Like,
oh no,
that's fine. And then just that's it. So then the lips. The easiest way to do it is to draw a little bit of a smile there, and then fill out the top with the type shape. Yeah, and then at the bottom it's just obviously the one. One. Mine is looking hideous. Yeah. I think it's because I'm doing it so slow.
It's because you're teaching.
It really doesn't look good.
Mine's not too.
It's not too tough with mine, to be fair.
I mean, the eyes are different shapes, but it's fine.
Right, next bit is painting. We're going to do the hair. So get your fattest brush. Yeah. And so brown. We're going to do a little bottom type bun here because it's going to be the quickest bit. So the best way to start is the fringe.
How quick you've done it.
Just do it so it's sort of like a side type pattern. That's it. And then your line at the top, because she's got really big hair, is as big as that.
Big blow dry.
This is always having big like blow dries, even the ponytails might say. That's it. Cool, and then this side, pretty much the same, but you're just doing it to there because she's got her hair up. It tucks in at the neck a little bit there.
Oh, I need more paint. Get too scared.
Don't worry, just throw it on. That's it. And then from that bit, just fill in, because it's probably going to be the easiest way for you to do it. So just basically
colour it in.
Just colour it in the brown. This is probably going to be the easiest way. I use a few different colours when I do it and blend them together, but.
I'm not there yet.
I think looking at mine today, I don't even think I'm there yet today.
How long does what just doing one bag take? Drawing.
It depends, sort of like a classic bag, about half an hour, Liz, would you say? About half an hour.
So,
yeah, so one of these from scratch, body, name, everything, takes about 30 to 40 minutes. But then I do like platinums, I don't know if you've seen them, where they've got like the full Disney background.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
They take sometimes up to 3 hours, depending on. Because it's like stages.
Oh god, it's like an eight, it's like.
The paint doesn't go very far, does it? You look fine though. Keep going, you're fine.
That's why I ruined it.
You've not ruined it. I'm drastically trying to make mine look better, but it's just not.
It's fine. It's good.
It's not up to my usual standards. I'm very disappointed with myself.
Is your driver at McDonald's?
Yeah, that's right. It actually looks a bit like the one that you drew, John, the new design.
Mine was awesome.
I'd say it was.
Really? Yeah, it's actually like absorbing it all.
Yeah, it does.
Right, you're doing well.
Yeah, you are.
She's got
thanks looking good.
It
does.
The first time you've ever done it.
I can't even tell you the last time I like held a paintbrush. I found a hat and like don't know how to do it.
But that's why I think people get confused with me, and because a lot say, well, why can't you do? Because I always say I'd love to do makeup because you work with paintbrushes. I'm like, makeup brushes and paintbrushes.
Oh no, they're completely different. This has not got a blending brush.
Would you say it's quite difficult?
Yeah. It's just you have to go through so much paint.
Yeah. I'll show you the production reel later so you'll see how much paint's in there.
Wow.
Yeah.
Get through a lot, don't we? Fab. So then it's fine if it's not, because you're coming down to do this bit here anyway. So for a side bun, right, hit this paint, it's like a big, think of just a bun sort of circle shape and just fill it all in.
Oh no, I've gone into the body.
Oh, it's fine, she's just got her hair onto her body, it's fine, don't panic.
I've got a bit cocky now,
but yeah. Just throwing it on. Yeah, so just like little bits. Oh. Yeah. That's fine. Just attach it to the bone.
I'm reading it now.
No, it's fine. So it's attached. Right, no, that's good. Right, so now you need your white with sort of this size brush.
Oh, white. Some dip down then. Oh no, I'm mixing them.
No, it's fine, don't worry, because it's going onto the brown anyway.
Put it in the water.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wait, is that
Yeah, that one. So then, just to create sort of the hair strokes, it's thin lines, you see, like this, coming from like the where your root sort of area would be, and then blending it into the brown.
Skills.
Yeah, so it's blended, it's a bit like makeup now. So you need to sort of blend it through so it's not like a harsh line.
Oh, is it like highlights?
Yeah. It just breaks up
too thick now.
The mass of hair. It's not a problem, just keep trying to blend it and it should work through. And then it's the same as well on this side.
You're going to want to employ me after this.
Are you going to want to be employed though, is the question.
Start on Monday.
Yeah. Christmas is coming, we could do with lots of elves.
I don't know, I've got dodgy eyes.
We know who painted that one. Mind you, it could be me right at that moment. My hand's a bit that way inclined. You can see how it just sort of breaks up the brown and looks like hair strokes. Yeah, just keep going around.
Minimizing.
Leave the bun at the minute and just sort of do the top root of the hair.
I'm the one who says it's therapeutic.
It is, a lot of people say that.
That's good air.
You are good. Somebody's going to win this masterpiece.
Oh my god, yeah, one of you guys are going to have this.
Don't confess at once.
There are other goodies as well.
Yeah,
it's not just
this.
It's back. No, that's good. So you just need one more at the top there. Now you're at the bun stage, so the bun is just basically a giant sort of swirl like that, and then add it to as well your little edgy bits that have come out the bun, just to soften that. So once you've done that, the easiest way to do it is to just keep going over and over it until it like blends through. Coming on to the tricky bit, because I'm desperate to see you paint an eye, so we're going to paint an eye.
Oh no.
So take your brush that's like that, the eyelashes are the hardest bit.
I think it's not going up.
Probably that's that one for now.
This one?
Yeah.
That'll do.
Yeah. So we do the whites of the eyes. So the whites of the eyes are these little corners here. I'm just going to do one eye first. And then we'll go maybe on to the next one. See, you've got this nailed.
You're looking good.
The face isn't going wrong now.
Right, blue.
Same paintbrush.
This one again.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, the flat one that you did the white with. I've not got long left and I really want you to show these eyelashes. Oh no, it's not you! See, because I want to see you do some eyelashes, so just literally...
Oh, then it likes fine legs.
And
right. Paint it in.
Yeah. And then in blue. See, you can't even find that.
Come on the white a little bit.
That's fine. Right, so now you need your thinnest brush and your black paint. Now this is like eyeliner-ish.
But I'm not going to do eyeliner, so it's a lie.
So outline the full of the eye, including the circle in the middle, in black.
Outline?
Yeah, so just go around your pen lines.
On the pen?
Black, yeah, where you've done the pen. It's the pressure.
It is.
It's the pressure.
The finished brush is out. It's the tricky work.
You're doing it fine.
I'm going out the eye as well.
No, we're going to do, well, you can do it to this corner here because that's where your eyelash comes from. Right, so to do an eyelash, I can't even really tell you how this goes, you'll just have to just watch it, because it's so hard to explain. So
confidence.
It's a flick. It's like a half circle flick. Let me see.
But when you get to the top bit, do you change direction?
No, when you get to the top, just come off, and then reapply the black.
I'm just going to
get back in. Just sort of think of a flick of the hand, it's like a little curve.
That's not bad actually,
no that's not bad. And then just keep going all the way along. Yeah, it doesn't last very long.
I think it's quite good. Definitely not, I'm ruining it now.
Well, we've got 30 seconds. 30 seconds, I'm sure we can fit in another two eyelashes.
Yeah, looking good.
nice.
They're good actually. Yeah. People really struggle with that, and you've not struggled. I think she could be at the top table doing eyelashes.
That's good.
Right, I'm just going to show everyone. That is a good first attempt.
Do you know what? It could have gone worse.
It could have. It's gone really well.
I didn't do art at school. But I'm going to finish it. One of you guys going to win it?
You're going to finish it completely?
Yeah. No.
No, just sign it. As long as you've signed it.
Okay, it's fine. Good.
Right, so we are, unfortunately, at the end of our Feel Good Fridays. I am no longer feeling good. I am feeling sad.
Oh.
What I want to finish off by saying is there is a huge competition now. All I need you to do is like, thumbs up, kiss, laugh, this post, all of those emojis. Comment below so I know that you've done it, and share this video of me and KD to all your friends and family. A winner will be announced and picked, and that winner will win £100 worth of Clarabella goodies or vouchers. And also, KD's signed bag. Also, what I also need to mention is our offer. So, as of today, it's on the website now, we have £10 across all jute bags. So that's these beautiful bags that you see here. So make sure you get your order in before Sunday, because that finishes on Sunday. Details of how to get them, etc., are on other posts on the Facebook page. I'm also going to ask Katie, I know I've painted this off her and she'd like to keep it, but would you sign this and I can give it away and I'll recreate it? So yeah. Katie's also going to sign this, so you will get her hand-drawn drawing by me, signed by Katie.
Look at me in your house.
And you get the bag as well, and then I'll do you another. So that's brilliant. So thank you everybody for watching this Feel Good Friday. Comment below, I'll answer all comments later. And have a fab Friday, a fab weekend, and have a glass of wine for us.
Yay.